Yo, thanks for clicking on this video. Just a YouTuber trying to make his way in the world. And I hope you stick around for this video. I hope you enjoy the video. If you do, you know what to do. Drop a like, subscribe, anything to support my channel. Anyway, that's the begging over. And yeah, here we go.
No, caught you.
Treachery. And anyone is. We should stay vigilant.
Get this. Some more shards.
The sun ring.
Stay off my focus.
Lucky if you survive long enough to wind up with them.
Shit, man. It's like Roman days gladiator Colosseum.
Now we get to see if your attack on their focus network was entirely successful. Success. Welcome to the Citadel, Aloy. I'll check back with you in a moment. In the meantime, circulate.
I had to load this shit up to get to this bit. Wonder what's about to happen.
Outlanders, if you want to hear about today's bounties, head for the throne room. You're not going to make any shards by standing out here.
Tread lightly, Outlander. I'm good at running.
I'll take the shards, even if it means having to listen to Bahavas.
By the glory of the sun revealed, behold, radiant Edomon, the one true Sun King, the light in shadow, whose will is light and whose light is law!
I command Lucian Bahavas to speak in my behalf.
By the will of Radiant Edomon does the sun glare down mercilessly upon the traitor Uthid. To the hunter who brings his head to us shall go a bounty of 500 shards.
More prisoners than royalty, don't you think? Love your hair. You and I need to chat, little huntress. The green tent down in Shadowside. I'll be waiting. Kind of busy. And in doing so, demonstrated wanton disregard for the safety. We both know you're no killer for hire. Uthid is innocent. So come see me while there's still time to save him.
So, the way in I spoke of is right behind you.
You've got to be kidding.
Not at all. And you needn't worry about the Kestrels. They'll be too busy acting important to pay attention to you.
First time in the Citadel. Gotta see the sun ring from on high.
Well, the Kestrels.
Ha! They want us to see
the balustrade.
It makes
it's a short drop from there. The balustrade. It's a short drop from there.
Okay. Oh, so I've got to jump down here. Sorry for the long silences. They're just like, there's a lot of dialogue, so I'm just gonna continuously get interrupted. What is she climbing up here for? Crap. I don't want to cock this up. Yeah, I need to climb down. What am I doing? There we go. No. Cut down. There we go.
The other side of the tower. Look for a vent.
Okay.
I see you've been here before.
Obviously. Now, it's very important that you hear what I'm about to say. I've shown you the way in. but this humble vent marks a point of no return. Before you descend to the depths here, you should be fully committed, equipped, and focused.
Okay. Well, let's,
no distractions. If you have errands to run, do them first or hold your peace. I won't tolerate whining. Is that clear?
Crystal.
You'll tolerate what I give you, Silence. I didn't ask you along for the ride. I'm heading down.
I've spent a lifetime trying to uncover the secrets of this world. Where the machines came from. How the old ones achieved such marvels only to fall into silence and death. A lifetime of failure. As year by year, decade after decade, I hit walls I could not break, doors I could never breach.
Hello.
Until Honora Huntress marched out of the savage east. And voila, for her, all the deepest secrets of the earth were laid bare. I suspect you will have an easier time with this door than I did years ago.
Hold for identiscan. Genetic profile confirmed. Entry authorized. Malfunction. 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 Malfunction.
Are you kidding me?
You don't hear me laughing.
Shut up. There's gotta be another way. Hey! Elizabeth Sobeck here! Requesting access!
Access request acknowledged. Root command functions available. Do you wish to proceed?
I do! Get me through this door!
Analyzing. Primary access inoperable due to mechanical failure. Emergency venting procedure likely to circumvent blockage. Do you wish to proceed?
Yes.
Emergency venting authorized.
Everything.
That will draw attention. We won't have this place to ourselves for long now.
We? Last I checked, I was the one risking my life down here.
Yes, fine. Now will you please get moving? There's so much to learn in less time than I'd hoped.
Oh, and about to uncover some secrets.
Project Zero Dawn.
Zero Dawn. We found it.
Are you really so surprised?
Facility diagnostics detect multiple failures. Attempting repair.
So, what was this room?
An entrance hall, perhaps. Have a look around.
Please take a seat and wait for your name to be called. A selection of beverages and snacks are available.
A smaller room.
God, that goddamn robot.
Please proceed into viewing room 5 for an important message regarding the purpose of your visit.
Talking down your nose. Right. What's in here? I got time to look at all these. I was doing some on time. Let's keep on pushing forward.
What was this place?
A holographic theater.
CD overrun data intact. Initiating playback.
Welcome to Project Zero Dawn. I am General Harris, Chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff of the United States of America. I'm sure you've heard the rumors. That Zero Dawn is a top-secret super-weapons program. The technological miracle that will save us from the Pharaoh Plague. If Operation Enduring Victory can hold off the robots long enough. The reason I'm sure you've heard the rumors is that I'm the one who spread them. And they are all lies. Zero Dawn is not a super-weapons program. And it will not save us. Nothing will save us. Here's why. By the time the glitch was noticed, it was already too late. Nothing could stop the Pharaoh Plague. Nothing can. Its robots will continue to replicate and devour the biosphere. Life on Earth will be destroyed. Our planet reduced to a barren sphere. Global extinction is inevitable. No matter how many we kill, the robots just keep exponentially making more. If we had their deactivation codes, we could shut them all down. The entire swarm. But since their cryptographic protocols use polyphasic entangled waveforms, cracking a code set would take half a century. At best, we've got 16 months. Not exactly what you'd call a survival option. The destruction of a biosphere is not the sort of apocalypse you can wait out in a fallout shelter or a space station. There will be no Earth left to reclaim. Just a lifeless, toxic rock with several million Pharaoh robots on it, hibernating. Waiting for something to eat. This is the horrible truth behind the lies of Operation Enduring Victory. My lies. Lies designed to inspire millions of innocents to sacrifice themselves in battle. Why? One reason. To buy time for you and the work you will do here. Zero Day. The day that life on Earth ceases to exist is coming fast. It cannot be stopped. The hope of Zero Dawn is that something new might come after. But I will leave it to Elizabeth Sobeck to shine that thin ray of light into the darkness. Harris, out.
That doesn't make sense. Life on Earth didn't cease to exist.
He said it could not be stopped.
But it was. Somehow Elizabeth saved us. I've got to keep looking. Find out how she did it.
Man, that's deep. Got to be, like, Aloy's got to be, like, is it ancestor of Elizabeth?
Kestrels. They got in. Through the vents.
Let nothing stop you from learning the truth.
Spread out! If it moves, kill it!
What is this place? Tomb?
Shit. We gotta go stealth here. Ooh. Right, guys there. Motherfuckers, man. Can't I just, like, explore this thing without any killer? Guess there's gotta be some sort of conflict. What can I take? Oh, health potion. Bye. Sorry. Flower. What can I upgrade? So I'm trying to look through these as quick as possible. I need a raccoon shell to get more potions. There we go, I've got the weapons. Satchel upgrade. Right. So I've just looked at that. I've scanned that already. I just can't wait to get to the end of this game to, like, find out, like, there's gonna be some crazy ass theory. Or crazy ass conclusion, sorry.
She's coming for us!
Fuck. Fuck. I didn't see that guy. Right, let's just jump down, shall we? Take your shards. Oh, look at all these audio tapes.
That is accurate, yes.
So these mechanical monstrosities, they don't just kill people. They feed off them?
Not just people. All organic matter.
Every living thing dissolves into nutrients. Millennia of evolution liquefied. The miracle of life reduced to...
I can pass them.
Bloody biofuel!
The data points, in a word,
you're going to ignore them?
Yes.
Who did this? Pharaoh? That arsehole. Is he here?
No, Doctor. Please,
Tell him Tom Pike what... Tell him Tom Pike what's the word.
Incoming!
Shit. I'm fucked up.
Please! You guys head fair right here!
Shit! Fucking die! There we go.
Too close to my tribal primitive stop us now. The data points, what did they contain?
So I just want to look at this beast. Fire Striker. Too heavy, man. So I'm going to collect all these data points. What's down here? Got a secret passage. Shit, where's this lead to? Am I going to be going this way? It's just like a little side thing we can do. That's just a little crawlio. I'm scanning all these. Taking my time. I need to collect all this fucking data. Right. More in here. It's in this door. Can't go through that. And that's probably missing. But that's all I can see. Oh, there's one there. I think we've already done that one. I think that's it. Right, let's go through this door.
CD02 data intact. Initiating playback.
Elizabeth Sobeck. You've heard the bad news, and it's all true. The Pharaoh Plague is devouring the biosphere. Life itself will cease to exist. But does that have to be the end? What if we could give life a future? What if we could build a kind of seed from which, on a dead planet, life could blossom anew? This is the aim, the hope, of Project Zero Dawn. To create a super intelligent, fully automated terraforming system and bring life back from lifelessness. What would such a system require? At its core, it would need a true AI, fully capable of making the trillions of decisions necessary to reconstitute the biosphere. An immortal guardian, devoted to the re-flourishing of life. We call it Gaia. Mother Nature as an AI. But that's just the core of the system. She will need to be surrounded and empowered by a comprehensive suite of subordinate functions. Think of them as extensions of Gaia's mind, each dedicated to a specific purpose. Now, these aren't AIs, but make no mistake, each presents an engineering challenge more profound than anything the human species has ever before attempted. Hardware that preserves and then gestates the billions of seeds and embryos from which life will be reborn. The construction of underground facilities to hold it all. And that's just the start. We don't have to build the entire system. The beauty of a fully automated terraforming system is that it can build itself. Now, over the days to come, you'll learn how all these functions, all these pieces that you'll be working on, fit together. How we'll race the clock to execute our harvest initiatives, write the software, build the tech and the facilities. How we'll lock it down and seal it up before the inevitable occurs. But even more important, you'll know how it doesn't end here. How Gaia will generate those deactivation codes General Harris talked about, and build the transmission arrays to broadcast them, shutting down the Pharaoh robots for good. how Gaia will not just build, but imagine any conceivable robot it needs to do its work across centuries. From detoxifying the Earth's ravaged atmosphere and poisoned seas, to the regreening of the Earth from cryopreserved seed stocks, to rewilding the Earth with animal life. And then, when all that is done, how a new generation of human beings, spawned at cradle facilities around the globe, will partake of Apollo, the vast archive of human knowledge and cultural achievement from which they will learn of us, our world. And most important, how not to repeat our mistakes. It's not an impossible dream. It is within our grasp if we work tirelessly and stop at nothing to achieve it. We can't stop life from ending. But if you will help me, help Gaia, we can give it a future. Join me and help make that future real.
Destroyed, but then remade?
Yes, by a machine. A machine of creation.
Elizabeth did this for life, for us. But why Hades then? If it was part of Gaia, how did it end up in the wreckage of a pharaoh robot? Why does it want to kill me? And Apollo, the Archive of Knowledge, what happened to that?
I'm as confused as you are. Maybe the answers lie ahead.
Wow. That blew my mind, that. Man, that was crazy. Oh, like, this game is like the storytelling and stuff. It's like film level. Whoever wrote this, man. Actually, the guy who wrote this was the guy who did the Fallout New Vegas, which I never played, but, man, guy deserves a fucking award. I really hope they do make another one of these. I hope this is the start of a new franchise. Because it's just been, maybe like a prequel, man, it's just been like unbelievable. See, man, this is the kind of games what don't make you just love to, like, I don't know, you're just glad you're a gamer, you're like, you're into your games, because you just miss out on stuff like this. It's not all Call of Duty and fucking Mortal Kombat and shit like that. It's like, not saying they're bad games. Just say, man, like, games like Uncharted, The Last of Us, Horizon Zero Dawn, Red Dead. They're the games, man. I know there's like a few others. Zelda, but I never played a Zelda, so yeah, I know. Kind of skipped that one. I probably should go and play them games because they're meant to be. I think about the new ones come out, obviously. Came out, I think, 2 days after this, I think. Came out the 3rd of March. So I might actually go back and play those.
Intruder! Get her!
Bad day for one of us.
Whatever you do, don't die now.
I haven't planned to. Whoa. These guys aren't fucking about her. Come on, burn, bitch! Gotta be careful here, man. I'm just gonna spam these arrows. I got plenty of health. So I'm not that worried. So I need to bust these out. Get myself some headshots! Right, he's fucked. Right, just this last one. As long as I get the headshots, I should be okay. There we go.
Is there another route?
I've done this before. Just need my focus.
Come on, man. I don't want that. Why do you keep picking these up? Please stop picking them up. Yeah, man, you've got stuff. Right up. Search this shadow heavy. Right. But I need to go through here. I'm trying to think of another game up blew my mind. I think Fallout 4, man, the story of that where... I don't know if you've seen the game. Actually, I won't reveal. I don't want to spoil it for people. I know there's got many people watching this, but... I try not to spoil shit. That's why I try with like certain thumbnails, I leave stuff out. I don't like thumbnails that spoil shit either.
Here we go. Another one of these. Need to find the right configuration.
Hey! I'm done with Brett's incompetence, okay? Somehow, he managed to install an H-emitter node backwards. Everything's in reverse. I don't get paid to clean up Brett's messes. If you want it fixed, send him up to storage for a new emitter, not me. Parker out.
Okay. Oh, it's not gonna be as simple as the last one, is it? What's this one say? Oh, left, down, right. Yeah, but these don't work. I feel like I've got to go climb somewhere. Oh, what's this one here? Yeah, this should tell me something. Yeah. What's this one say? Left, up, left, down. Right, so I'll turn this counterclockwise. I'm gonna leave that one. Counterclockwise again. That's down. Next one. No, I think the next one, last one was right. Yeah. I hope it works.
Done. I should check the door nearby.
Okay. There we go. So I wonder, like, that Hades guy, is he like, I don't know, a robot gone wrong or something like that? Like, obviously by the game, the Hades, obviously the game's after all these different systems. Sorry, I need to go back and watch that again because there were quite a lot of information to take in. But like, you know, you got all the gods, Poseidon, Apollo, get rid of the other ones. Figure Kratos, that's God of War. I feel like I'm going the wrong way. Yeah, I think I just need to go upstairs though. This is where I came from. Sorry. And I'm fucked up. Yes, I want to climb up here, though. Sorry, blabbing away. Now I'll go through here.
Found one. Looks intact.
I'll go across this tightrope. Yeah, give me that. Alright, we should be able to sort this out. Where am I going? Am I going the right way? There we go.
That should do the trick. Get that door open.
So, alright, counterclockwise. Go. Then, down. Successful. Yeah, well, that one's good down. There we go. Here we go. Yeah. That's the right way. Up, left, down, right. Oh, yeah. It's upside down. Because you did say something about it might be messed up. So that one's go down. Try to fuck with me, didn't you? I'm on to you. Now let's go that way. Not that way. That way. This one goes go up. So I'm trying to picture it, what it looked like if it was the way around. So I feel like I've got these. I feel like I messed this one up. Yeah, I think it's these two. Right, this should work now, hopefully.
That did it. Door should have power.
Now to see what lies beyond it.
I get this. Right. Let's see what's behind door number one.
They're here.
Avoid contact.
Lines look good.
Gaia, it's up there. Second floor.
Can you reach it?
So much for avoiding contact.
Oh. Let's get these crafted. Yeah, bitch. You never saw it coming. Come on. Take your head out, bro. Whoa, what the hell have they got? That's what I need some of those. I think after I've done this mission, I'm going to find out. I can get some different ammo. Well, I know I can. Just need to find out where to get it. Come on. Headshot. There we go. I can't even see that guy. Best off killing him bees and then picking up the loot.
Not sure what that was.
Or not.
To me, brothers.
Whoa, this is what I need to do. Fire. This shit. Come on, motherfuckers. Yeah, more feed now, bitch.
Try a run. You cannot escape our
ground. Whoa. Whoa. Come on, man, this is tense. I'm too tired for this shit. Come on. It's so bad.
Room's clear. For a moment, anyway.
Then get moving. You have to find Gaia.
Tell you what, fuck all this shit, man. So actually, I think I've got time just to pick a few things up. Come on, get these shards. Yeah.
I can't stand the wait.
I don't think there's no urgency to get this done. Out. Bug. Ooh. we've got more of these. More shards. Some shrooms. There's this shit on it. More shrooms. Scan the map quick. Oh, I think it's good. Let's just go.
Hello, I'm Margot Shen, and this is Hephaestus. As the name might tip you off, this is going to be the subordinate function that Gaia will use to make lots and lots of robots. Her personal forge. Except, it's not that simple. You probably noticed that only about a third of you are robotics engineers. The rest, experts in machine cognition, virtual heuristics, that stuff. Well, that's because we aren't going to be the ones designing and building robots. The last thing we want is to burden Gaia with a bunch of outmoded 21st century designs. Waste of time. Our purpose is to empower Gaia to build the robots, and not just build, imagine, from scratch. Any robot she needs for any conceivable purpose, designed and fabricated at a snap of a finger. Hers. Her finger. So, Hephaestus isn't really the forge. It's more like the knowledge of craft and ingenuity of a mastersmith to wield the hammer. Encoded as software. Virtual creativity made real. Gaia's already learning. In simulation, she's doing some very creative things with fractal assembly and animal morphologies. Her designs aren't about to win the Liam Prize anytime soon, but hey, everyone has to start somewhere. So, yes, time to get started. Let's do this.
I don't get it.
Which part? It's a little technical in places.
If Gaia was designed to save life, why would the robots it makes attack people?
Perhaps it loves some forms of life more than others.
The derangement. The machines weren't always so angry.
True. Mostly they were docile until 10-15 years ago.
For years, Hephaestus has been forcing cauldrons to make aggressive machines. I've seen it myself, in the cauldrons. Stalkers, ravagers, the Thunderjaw. How could it do that? And why?
Why indeed?
Yeah. Let's scan some more of these data points. Oh, supply crate, nice.
I've seen them before. In a cauldron.
You've been inside a cauldron?
An abandoned one, yes.
So, the cauldrons... they belong to Gaia?
It would appear so. The birthing places of her machines.
Sorry, I'm just, making sure I scan everything. This, what's this do?
Shen, and this
I've
is
already
Hephaestus.
Seen this.
As
you again.
To tip you off, this is going to be the subordinate function that Gaia will use to make lots and lots of robots. Her
let's keep on going forward. You have to see here. Yeah, we were down there, weren't we? Ooh. Oh, this is where, actually. This is where we saw the first hologram. And she was giving the speech about the Earth and stuff. I think it is. So remember that glass bit looking through the glass? I'm not sure. I could be completely wrong.
I think this is it. Elizabeth Sobek's office. But it's sealed off. There's got to be a way inside. More Eclipse.
Careful now.
Tell you what, this reminds me of Batman actually. The way they highlight the enemies. Go to your Batman mode. I'm going for all my favourites. Even though the last one was a bit... iffy. Not a bad game, just maybe... third time round, kind of... well... if you count Origins, fourth time round. Kind of bored of it, to be honest.
Welcome to Apollo, the collective memory of the human species and the wellspring of knowledge for future generations. I am Samina Ebaji. Until recently, I was director of the International Collective Memory Institute in New Tehran.
As a heritage professional, I devoted my career to the preservation of human knowledge, creative endeavor, and cultural achievement. Apollo is, therefore, the ultimate embodiment of a lifelong passion, albeit under the very worst circumstances imaginable. The challenges before us are immense. Specifically, we will have to design and implement 4 major initiatives simultaneously.
Yeah, think about that Batman game. I think it just like played it too safe.
The construction of data repositories in cradle facilities around the world, ensuring redundancy. Second, the collection and processing of a projected 180 million discrete data entries. 42 zettabytes of data in Mandarin, English, Spanish, and Arabic. Third, the transfer and encoding of all that data onto DNA
in synthetic fossils. So I'm trying to listen to what she's saying.
Only medium capacious and durable enough to safeguard it without degradation for the centuries to come.
Anything else? We got cut a shot. Wonder if I'll come back in a hologram. Actually, I don't think that ever happened. No one gives a fuck what I've got to say. I'm Double L. Welcome to my channel. Ooh, what's this guy saying? Oh, is that a fucking glitch? He's stuck into the box. It's my dick in the box. Right. I'm doing good so far, but I don't want to jinx it. Ooh, look at this guy. Yeah. You just got fucked, son. Stealthy. Take this guy out. There we go. Nice. He didn't know what hit him. I'm not sure, these are levels 6. So he's a 50.
There,
oh. Holy shit. It was all going so well. I ruined it. Oh. Right. Shit. I botched that up there. There we go. This guy. Fucking eat it! Right, you get the headshot! Oh!
In what should have been a cave of wonders, look around. See if anything is left.
Man, that guy needs to chillax. Fuck it. Can't get yourself a heart attack there, buddy. I'm like sliding around and shit. I'll see something right quick. Yeah, I was just testing that. Seeing like, cause I know when she slides, like dirt comes up. I'll see if I'm gonna do it. Just some little things like that. If there'd been dirt and I stood on this metal bit here, I'd be like, yeah. You done fucked up. It's like certain things like in a game, like, I don't know. You walk on snow, leave a footprint. Actually, does it leave footprints in here? I don't know, it does. I should try that in like a snow area. This is like frosty. Sorry, I just like to have a good old look around. So I know I'm gonna miss some shit. Right, I'm just double checking everywhere. Have you not here? No, I don't think so. Ah, that's it. Got these little ones. Diddy-daddies. I love sliding.
Easy.
Alright, sorry.
Welcome to Hades. Zero Dawn's extinction failsafe protocol. The ultimate killer app. Now, I know what you're thinking. The purpose of Gaia is to resurrect life. So why give her a subordinate function, only purpose of which is to wipe out life all over again? I mean, what the... what? Just plumb crazy, ain't it? Well, no, it isn't. Reconstituting a buyer? That's a tall order. Tech smart as Gaia may be, odds are she won't get it right the first time. I mean, imagine you're Gaia. 200 years from now, and this new biosphere growing, it's all gone wrong. Alkalines are skyrocketing, coniferous forests eroding under the lash of superstorms that would have drowned Noah. It's chaos. A spinning top that won't stop wobbling. Now what are you gonna do? Release phase one organisms into that hot mess? Hope their CO2 and methane can balance out what you got started? Hell no. What you're gonna do, Gaia, is step aside while Hades takes over and does what you're just too darn nurturing and life-loving to do, which is burn that misbegotten mess of a biosphere to the ground so Gaia can start over. Okay, not burn, more like reverse terraforming operations and suffocating. But you get the idea. Hades takes the biosphere back to zero. Square one, blank slate. And then, only then does it hand the steering wheel back to Gaia and say, try again, old girl. And better this time, or we'll have to do this again. That's Hades. It's pretty badass when you think about it. Extinction on demand. Death on speed dial. All for the greater good, of course, but still, kind of metal. So welcome to Hades. Welcome to the void.
Okay, so if that's the original purpose of Hades, why does it want me extinct?
We need more data.
And how does it end up in the wreckage of a Pharaoh Titan, getting worshipped by the Eclipse like some kind of god?
I'm learning as you are, Aloy. Keep searching.
Gaia kind of a douche, why? It might be crazy, like, if these people in the holograms actually guys who worked on the game, the developers. I doubt it. Would be nice though. Like how they like design the characters. They must do that, right? They just make up random people like the, well, the design them, don't they, like, obviously after the voice actors portraying them. I'm just thinking about Last of Us and
looks like the only way onwards.
Uncharted used that motion capture stuff. Like the guy who plays Nathan Drake. Was just rolling off.
Welcome to Eleuthia, the crown and king of Gaia's subordinate functions. For it is by Eleuthia that the human race will continue to exist. I am Patrick Brochard-Klein, the Alpha in charge of this program. Now let one thing be perfectly clear from the outset. Eleuthia is not a genetic engineering project. Our goal is to preserve the human genome, not alter it. A snapshot of human genetic diversity, literally frozen in time. The genetic quintessence of our species, unmodified. Under my watch, our activities and initiatives will comply with the 2034 clone provisions and the 2048 rally accords. Now that may seem a quaint, even trivial concern to you in light of present circumstances, but as one of the authors of the accords, it is far from trivial to me. The practical challenges before us are staggering in scope and complexity, but
not insurmountable. No. Global collation and provisional storage of zygotes. Perfection of exogenic technologies. Design and perfection of servitors. To provide nurture and inculcation during early child development, all of these program components must and will proceed in tandem. To say nothing of the breakneck construction of cradle facilities at sites around the world. So, si vous êtes prêts, let us begin.
So I'm just gonna have to listen to all of these. I feel like it's vital for the story to find out as much as possible. Probably kind of talk. Oh shit! That's why I'm trying to stand still, because I don't want because at the time they were like overlapping each other. Aliens, Asylum, trying to talk and like you couldn't hear what they were saying. So I apologize for that. But yeah, I'm just looking. These look like that cryogenic, well, I don't know what it's called. Freezing people in time.
No room.
Oh, bastard. I need to get a bigger pouch. I keep saying that. I keep forgetting.
Cradle facilities. Elizabeth said a new generation of humans would be spawned inside such places.
She did.
Oh, Mother Mountain. It was one of them?
There's only one way to be sure.
The hatch wouldn't open. Something about a corrupted Alpha registry. I need to search Elizabeth's office.
Right, let's, I think it's down, or aren't we? We're going down. Why would they hit this ladder here for? Yeah. Don't have that ladder there for no reason. I don't think he can dive into water in this, he can just do like a stealthy swim. Right.
Pure logic won't cut it, Ted. To pull this off, Gaia's going to need to have some skin in the game. It has to care.
What if it runs amok? Have we learned nothing from our mistakes?
Your mistakes, I think you mean?
All I'm saying is, give it a kill switch.
She was just born, Ted. I'm not gonna put a gun to her head while she's still in the cradle.
You talk like it's a child. What if it becomes a monster?
Elizabeth, may I speak outside protocol?
Of course, Gaia, go on.
I'm sorry to contradict you, but Mr. Pharaoh's argument is sound. At this point, the development of my psyche is not entirely predictable. To ensure preservation of life, a hardwired override is, I believe, a necessary safeguard.
There. Satisfied, Ted?
Jeez, Liz, just do what it says.
Okay. Now we are finding out loads of shit here. Too much information, man. I need to go back and watch that shit.
Would benefit from antilopine morphologies, though caprid forms show superior load-bearing capability.
You're a quick study, Gaia.
Dr. Sobek, as I have conducted this comparative analysis of mammalian morphologies, I've gathered extensive data on the quaternary extinction event.
Oh? And your assessment? Gaia?
Logically speaking, the extinction was a natural consequence.
And yet,
I find the loss of megafaunal species unaccountably sad. Though they passed forever into oblivion, causes me to experience a grief that is difficult to describe. Am I malfunctioning?
No, Gaia, you're not. This is good. It's very good.
Is that it? I'm saying the voice actor for Elizabeth sounds exactly like Aloy. Probably is the same person.
You will undergo a brief period of unconsciousness during relocation to Prime and final instatement.
Elizabeth,
May I speak outside protocol?
When you're back up and running at the new site, we'll bring the subordinate functions online and see where we stand.
Elizabeth, I detect distress. Are you all right?
I'm fine.
I realize that circumstances compel us to launch earlier than we hoped, but all subsystems are operational. The odds stand in our favor.
But what if... Guy, there's nothing left out there. You can't even survive unless you're wearing an environmental suit. There are billions dead, in fear and agony. What if it was all for nothing?
Elizabeth, extinction was inevitable. Thanks to you, life will have a future.
You really believe that?
I believe in you, Elizabeth. In you, all things.
Oh, no. Bastard. Man, now we're getting deep. Poor Elizabeth. I don't think nothing like this happens in the future. We are doomed.